Very good morning, everyone, and welcome to today's market commentary. So on Nifty's daily time frame chart, price took a bounce near 10,930 and it had now started going upwards. Now for that to be bullish, it needs to cross above 11,080. So above 11,080, we can see 90 point upward movement in Nifty, at least until near prior lifetime high. So on daily time frame chart, this thing is very clearly visible to us. Price was moving in a range from 10,930 to 11,080. This was the range which Nifty maintained since few trading days. Now, since the output of GST was very positive, that might give a good boost for Nifty in its upward journey. And we can see 11,170 coming either in this month or in this expiry or in the next expiry. Since we have only very few days for this expiry, only four trading days remaining. So we can expect this to happen at least in the next expiry. So Nifty, this was the view. Now, even in last market commentary also we saw, although Bank Nifty opened below the trendline support, it didn't sustain there. Even today also, it opened here at 26,700 and again it is continuing its bullish journey. So this might not be valid now. So only thing which is very clearly visible even here also, that Bank Nifty is also maintaining a range in between 26,650 to 27,200. So Bank Nifty will be bearish below this range, that is on the downside, and it will be bullish on the upside. So Nifty and Bank Nifty, mostly these are the only possible things that we can derive. But RSI is not helping both of them, trading below 60 level. So, and Nifty RSI is currently above 60. So that's a good news. So momentum is picking up in Nifty. So we can see Nifty breaking its resistance level. And by the time it breaks its resistance level, it also needs to break its prior RSI top, and that will give a huge momentum to Nifty on the upside. So for Bank Nifty and Nifty, these are the views. Because both are trading in range bound sessions, we should wait until that range is taken out. Bullish or bearish, we need to wait until the range is taken out. Now we have some stocks that we have picked up. Let's see all these stocks or whichever are possible in our time frame. So Bata, Havells, all these were in my stock list, screener list. So today opening session itself, they gave a very good rally up. So that was a symmetric triangle here and the major resistance was near 850. But the stock opened at 875. So more than 3 to 4% up. Next, even Havells also, there was a small triangle pattern, and when price opened above the resistance level from the starting of the day itself, from 575, the high made today is around 609. So this is all because where was the price trading? Above the central pivot point and above 20 period moving average. So since it gave a breakout on the upside, there was a very good momentum, and intraday session itself on Friday, the RSI value was above 50 level. So 50 to 60, we can search for bullish opportunities, and the same has happened here. So above 50 today, until now RSI registered value is 71.7. So that is the power of finding resistances in the bullish zone and finding supports in the bearish zone. So once that resistance level is broken, you can immediately start establishing your position in that particular stock. So Havells and Bata were rockers today. Now we have the other stocks also. So IGL is approaching its resistance now. So even this stock is above both the bullish zones. So as per the both indicators, the stock is in bullish zone currently. So the immediate resistance for IGL should be 288.6, and value of RSI is also above 60. So this stock should be kept in your watch list. And Exide Industries is facing a resistance near the trendline resistance. Once we have a break out of this trendline resistance, so 275 is your first target, and it can perform like Havells if it can give a breakout above 275. Now the supporting factors: RSI trading above 50, price above central pivot point and 20 period moving average. So from now on, what I will say is, if price is trading above central pivot point and 20 period moving average, I'll consider that as bullish zone. So I'll not say again and again that price is above pivot, price is above moving average. From now on, I'll say that price is in bullish zone, and we'll wait for the break of resistance. So that was Exide Industries. Gail India, we have the breakout of this small trendline resistance here. When we connect the highs of all these four candles, that became a small trendline resistance. So above the trendline resistance, that is around 362. 362 was your entry price, and 365 was registered today. So that is around less than 1% of profit. Now just wait until, if you did not get a chance to establish your positions above the trend line, wait until 366.5 is taken out, then 374.35 can be seen. Now one more important factor here would be, price is making higher highs every time. So these are all higher swing lows. So that shows an increase in momentum, and even RSI is also trading above 60. As per both the indicators, price is in bullish zone. So we'll await a breakout of 366.5, and 375 should be our target. Even Kaveri Seeds also, RSI above 60, and price is in bullish zone as per both the indicators. Now for this stock, above 595, 610 should be your target. So 4% of profit can be expected if this particular stock breaks 595. Most important at every point of time is, are there any supporting factors for your judgment or not? So Adani Ports, it just gave a breakout. So 376 and high is 380. So already 1% is given in intraday. But for this particular stock, target should be 392. RSI is, if you see the direction of RSI, even it is making a swing lows, higher lows that too. And the previous stop is also broken. And that happened today itself. So it doesn't have any resistance until this peak. So RSI is having a chance to reach at least until 65.48. So that is also a good sign of bullishness. As of now, it is trading above 50. So that is a bullish zone. And as for the both the indicators, price is above the bullish zone. So keep this stock also in your watch list. So Ajanta Pharma, until now in today's session, it faced a stiff resistance near the trendline resistance. So just let me zoom out a bit. So how did we get this trendline resistance? Starting from this high, when we connected this high and extended it towards the right, even Friday's candle also acted as a strong resistance. Now it started moving up. So until now, until we started our market commentary, it was in bearish zone. But the supporting factors, if you see, RSI is above 50 and as per the indicators, it is above in it is in the bullish zone. So you should never get deceived when price is showing you bearishness if it is in the bullish zone and if it is at the verge of breaking out the resistance. You should just wait patiently until the resistance is broken. You should not take it out from your watch list, because that might be deceiving you, or it might be a bearish trap. So if you try to be on bear side when the price reached resistance, and when it is in bullish zone, you should not be on bearish side. Even RSI is also increasing now. It took clear support near 40. We know that 40 to 60 is a sideways zone, and when price is in bullish zone, it will take support near 40 and again it will bounce back. Now just imagine, if RSI takes out its previous high of 60, there's no other resistance as far as RSI is considered. So the next resistance is at 73. Above 60, the next value of RSI that it can reach is 73. So this 1126 can be easily reached by Ajanta Pharma if RSI reach if it will go above 60. So you should keep this stock in your watch list and try to trade this. So Balkrishna Industries also, RSI is facing a resistance near 60, but as per the indicators, it is in bullish zone as of now. What we'll do is, we'll wait until the resistance is broken. Until then, we'll not take any trade. And when it bounced back here, or when it was here, that was the best part to enter the trade if you were a reversal trader. But now it is not advised to enter here. We'll wait until this 1270 level is taken out. At least for the next expiry, we can aim until 1354. So Seat Tyres, already on Friday, it broke out the immediate trendline resistance. And within the intraday itself, you can see from the breakout point of 1300, the high made on the day was 1383. So 83 rupees of upward movement could be seen. And it took support near the long-term support level. That was the first supporting factor. And now when it broke the trendline resistance, it already entered the bullish zone. Now the red candle which you're seeing here, that is actually the profit booking happening. So let it happen. Our entry point should be above 1417. Why? Because earlier that level acted as a support. When price broke that level, it again acted as resistance. So for the third time, when price comes here and if it closes above this, we can immediately enter the bullish trade, and our target is very high this time, 1668. Or 1665 to be precise. So above 1420, our target is 240 points above. So we have a long target coming up in Seat, but we need to wait until this resistance level is taken out. Even HCL Technologies is facing a resistance near trendline resistance. Now, where should we enter in this stock? This is the exact position. 1020 should be your entry point here. Now, above 1020, your next target should be the previous high, which is 1108. So in HCL Tech, above 1020, it will be crossing this trendline resistance, and it will be crossing the prior swing high also, from where we could see a very clear evening star pattern. This is a green candle, gap up doji, and gap down red candle, which covered the body of this complete green candle. So this is a perfect evening star pattern. So we want this evening star pattern top to be taken out. So above this, bulls will get stronger again. So we'll participate only in that bullish rally. And we don't have any clear resistance on the left side also. Now, do we have any supporting factor? Yes, RSI is above 60 level. And price is in the bullish zone. So we have all the supporting factors on the bullish side. Even Just Dial also broke out. Since many market commentaries, we have been seeing this. Although it opened gap up, it is not able to sustain. So that is the reason we always tell you, even though if there is a trend line resistance and above that, if you find any horizontal resistance, that should be your entry point. So first, let me remove the indicator here. So what I'm saying is, although there was a trend line resistance and price broke out of the trend line resistance today, it started coming down. So your entry point always should be above the horizontal resistance. Now let's see if it can take support near this trend line support or not. We'll come to know that only by the end of the day. So even LIC Housing Finance, there's a trend line resistance and there's a horizontal resistance. So you should enter only above the horizontal resistance. Now this horizontal resistance also is not a powerful one, because that was just a high that we could see, prior swing high, but this is a minute flag pattern. So let me draw that flag pattern. So from here, price went up and a small falling channel could be seen. So this is the flag pattern that we could observe. Now RSI is above 60, so you should be on bullish side. Now can we consider this as a breakout of flag pattern? As of now, we cannot consider that because price needs to sustain clearly above this flag pattern. But if you see, it is forming a doji pattern. This is just 1 hour after the market has started today. So we should wait until the day end. Now finally, where should we enter? Only above the top of the pole. So that comes to be around 526.5. So above 526.5, we'll be bullish in LIC Housing Finance until 556. So even this is also a 6% of movement can be seen in LIC Housing Finance if it closes above the 526 level. Even Maruti is also at the verge of a breakout, but it needs some more momentum to break on the upside. So first of all, we have a trend line resistance here and we also have a flag pattern even in Maruti. So this is the flag pattern in Maruti. Now when this upper blue line gets broken, the flag pattern will get activated and we need to enter the stock above 9550, which is the prior top. So above 9550, our first target should be 9720 and the second target you need to trail until the prior top is reached. So first 200 point can be reached easily, but the next 300 point you need to trail your profits. So Maruti is at the verge of breaking the flag pattern. So keep an eye on that. Even Motherson Sumi is also facing a resistance near the trend line resistance here. So above this trend line resistance, we need to be bullish, and above that 308 to 317 should be our target. So this is a short term target. NIT Technologies also, we can see it's a slight triangle pattern here, not a perfect one though, but we are playing out with the trend line resistance here. So where will be bullishness started in NIT? Above 1168. So above 1168, small target you need to adjust, and above 1193, you just need to trail your profits. And finally, in the bullish script, RBL Bank. So price is making higher swings, but problem is it is facing resistance near RSI 60 level. So once it breaks this trend line resistance, RSI should be above 60, and if it breaks below this trend line support, RSI should be below 40. Then you can enter on the side of the breakout. So in Godrej CP, we have a pattern like double top here, and this is the neckline come support line. So below 1274, 1240 is your first target, and 1155 should be your next target. So first let me mark the double top pattern here. So this is the first top. So this is the double top pattern that can be seen, and not only that, so if you observe the high of this green candle, price faced the resistance there. Until this green candle broke out the high of this green candle, none of the candles could break that. So we can take this as a resistance, 1276, and even on Friday also the low was around 1276. So this stock will enter bearish zone only if this 1276 is broken. Now to be on bullish side, this high itself is your resistance. So we have a zone here, resistance zone. So if this resistance zone is taken out, you can be bullish on this stock. So this double top pattern will get invalidated. Now since RSI is also above 60, so this might have more chances. Stock being on bullish side and price is also above the bullish zone, so mostly we might have a bullish opportunity in this stock. So we have two stocks from our participants. First is ITC. So ITC, there's a break of triangle pattern, and that was an awesome break here from 280. Today's high is 286.65, so around 3% of profit, and this is your final target in ITC for this month, maximum of 290. The next stock is Bank of India. A trendline resistance in Bank of India and RSI climbing up. So this is the next level of resistance for RSI, and for the price also this is the next level of resistance. So there's actually a resistance zone here, because earlier price was taking support near this zone. So we can be bullish in this particular stock only if this resistance zone is taken out. So the support zone now got converted into resistance zone, and here you can see price was not able to breach that resistance zone. So to be bullish in Bank of India, for long term bullishness it needs to close above 93, and for short term bullishness it needs to close above this trend line resistance, and you can trade until 91.4. Now the other supporting factors, if you see, there's a confluence of resistance here. 20 period moving average in confluence with the trend line resistance. So once price closes above this trend line resistance, it is in turn closing above the 20 period moving average also. So 91.4 to 93 should be your target. You should settle down with that. Or else if it is closing above 93, you can just trail your profits at least until 104.85. Next is LNT. So price is facing a resistance at the 20 period moving average. See this green candle of Friday. The closing price was below 20 period moving average, and even today also, although it made a high above that, it is not able to sustain and came back. Now for short term bearishness, below 1243 you can short the stock until 1206.1. RSI is also below 50, so slightly below the bearish zone, and price is also below central pivot point, so it is looking bearish as per the indicators and as per the plane chart. So these are the stocks and indices for today. Thank you all for joining.